Hello guys, this is Shaky Beavs and welcome to another episode of my Demon Souls remake on PlayStation 5, formerly the Reaper Scythe playthrough. We are now moving on to the Winged Spear, and this is a dex build playthrough of this fantastic game on PlayStation 5. And we are in, for me, a highlight area of the series so far. Tower of Latria, Prison of Hope, is an absolutely stunning area and it can't be understated. I hope it comes across via the rather quashed version of the video you'll see on YouTube. Playing it is just an incredible experience. The audio, the visuals come together in a way that's just fascinating. For those that may not have heard on previous videos, or you've just picked up this one, I'm playing this blind, so I'm trying to play it without Googling anything, going on Extra Life, etc. I'm trying to experience the game in its purest form, and I'm enjoying it more because of that. We do run into a hurdle this episode that maybe some comments below from you guys would certainly help with, and that is the Fool's Idol boss. I don't know what's going on. You beat the boss and then it's not over. You can go back in and keep playing it for eternity and the boss kind of mocks you. So that's a really interesting hook that I didn't see coming. So I've now got to figure out, without the use of the internet, how I'm going to get past that. And I'm sure there's an item I'm missing or a strategy, I'm not sure. So yeah, as I'm playing blind, I mean, I did watch this on PS3 back in the day. I've watched kind of playthroughs, and this area always struck me as somewhere that just looked fascinating. So getting to play it with this level of fidelity, with this level of production values, is just great. It's an absolute dream come true. So good to share this with you guys. So it's probably worth mentioning, in fact, I have got a caveat this episode. I had a bit of a gut punch moment. I lost a chunk of footage and a really satisfying and interesting part of the footage, which is really, really quite upsetting. There's a huge ballista that you're going to see, a very kind of iconic moment in the level with this huge towering ballista. I haven't got the footage where I managed to get the shortcut and go around that and turn off the ballista. And I also miss another bit of footage, which is me unlocking the prison cell where the Sage Freck is residing, or Freak, not sure how you pronounce that. But at the Nexus, there's a few characters that talk about Sage Freck, or one character rather talks about him, that he's a rather formidable sorcerer. So it's going to be interesting to see him now populate back at the Nexus. But those two moments, unfortunately, despite the fact very satisfying gameplay moments, I haven't got the footage, I lost it. So really, really sad. It added that level of richness to the episode. That being said, there's still lots of rich moments and lots of interesting moments. So the majority of my playthrough of Latria is still here. It's just those couple of moments for me that would have definitely been in the episode had I not lost the footage. So sorry about that one, guys. So this episode will close out with Fool's Idol, and we will definitely have to pick up some more gameplay in Latria to understand what's going on with the Fool's Idol and start looping back to pick up items I may have missed. There's still a few secrets to uncover for sure. My build, it's probably worth mentioning, is high dex, I think, for this level of gameplay. I've got 30 points in dex at this stage. By the close of the episode, I have 20 in vitality and 18 in endurance, and that's pretty much it. So now I'm going to focus on ploughing more and more points into dex. The way that I build my characters, and you'll see that if you're familiar with my channel and you've watched the other series I've done, I go for the kind of glass cannon builds whereby I try to ignore vitality for as long as possible. I don't feel, and this is just my personal take, that you should have a character that's basically just, you know, a punch bag that can take as many hits as possible and you can still get the win. That for me is not very satisfying. You know, I want to do it with a level of skill at least where I have got a level of vulnerability, but at the same time, I'm going to do huge damage output. That's what I kind of like. It's that high risk reward feeling that I think these games are actually about. You know, that's the fundamentals of the game. So building my character to that kind of gameplay style is what I like. So I will ignore vitality for as long as I can. And I always get caught out on endurance and end up having to put a few points on that with some of the later, more endurance sapping boss fights that you do come across later on. So that'll probably be the arc for my character. But yeah, the two-handed spear is actually a really great weapon. I'm enjoying it. Incredible range. I talked about this on the last video. It was great against Flame Lurker. The damage output is superb, so it seems to be scaling really nicely with dex, which was good because it was a slight punt for me. It's now scaling at C, and I presume once I get it to 10, it might go up to B in terms of the bonus that I'll get from my dex attribute level up. But yeah, you know, for me that's an aggressive player, having the two-handed damage buff that you get is quite significant. The damage scaling from going from one-handed to two-handed is actually very significant, and you'll have seen that in my last episode versus Flame Lurker. So great for me as an aggressive player, but if I want to, I can also have the option of holding up my shield and pokey-poking away with that lovely spear of mine. So there you go, guys. That's it from me. Enjoy the episode, and I'll see you on the next one. All the best. Yes! Yes!
Yes! You're still intact, aren't you? Where do you call home? Dear me, I shouldn't pry. Oh, perhaps you'd like something from my collection. I've known better days. I was once the wife of nobility, and I have some nice things to show for it. Before, there were many others trapped here, but they were driven mad and ventured above of their own volition. Redemption. There exists no such thing. The Queen banished that depraved old man from the land. He returned in strange golden garb with foul demons in tow. They pillaged Great Latria, land of the learned, and shut us away in this prison. Since then, they've been feeding off our souls. Telling us over and over that if we go above, we will be granted redemption. I know the truth. The Church Goddess may die, but never for long. We are trapped below forever. Redemption. There exists no such thing. Telling us over and over that...
You are a sane one, are you not? My name is Rydell. Please, liberate me from this jail. I have precious little time. I must retrieve an article from my corpse. As you can see, the only thing that remains of me is my soul. My corpse lies in another cell. I fancy it a fine, rotten mess by now. I've no interest in my corporeal flesh, but I left upon my person a keepsake of my late wife. I will soon fade into the beyond. My only wish is to do so near that token of my beloved. A retainer to the king once held the key to this cell. That foul pig with his gluttonous swaying belly. As you can see, the only thing...
do you want? I am but a humble servant. I do not wish to interfere. I won't cause you trouble. I won't. What do you want? I am but a humble servant. I do not wish to interfere. I won't cause you trouble.
Ha ha ha.